Kyle Myra, and you might notice Kyle is a younger inventor. At only age 17, he's here at the Colorado Inventor Showcase. Kyle, tell us about your invention.
I invented the spot sucker, and I came up with it because I spilled some Gatorade on my shirt, and I'm kind of a lazy kid, and so I saw some Kleenexes, and I saw I could try to scrub it out with the Kleenexes, but knew that it would just kind of deteriorate, not really work. So I kind of thought to myself, why couldn't you have a pump? It actually sucks out that stain and removes that stain. And I went home, thought about it a little bit more, and that's where I came up with the spot sucker.
So tell me, after you conceptualized the idea, what was the next step?
Inventing is this crazy thing. Everybody has ideas, and the hard part is getting them out there. And so now I went home and I thought about it more, and then I came up with my proof of concept prototype. And now we're just trying to get out there and license it so we can sell the idea to some company that will then sell the product.
Can you imagine walking through Target or Walmart at age 17, looking at the shelf going, that's my product right there, I invented that?
No, I mean, that'd be a dream come true. That'd be unbelievable.
Do the other kids at your school know that you're an inventor? I mean, do they know you're here today?
A lot of them knew that I was on American Inventor. Some of them know I was here today. I don't know. Like, I think I'm kind of quiet about it, and I'm waiting for, I don't know.
You're waiting for your millions. We know. Yeah. We know you're waiting for your big shot, right?
I'm waiting for my product, and then I can be like, yeah, that's mine.
That is so exciting. Kyle, we wish you all the best this year. Okay. And obviously, as you go forward getting this product to market, look for it on a TV infomercial near you. Kyle Myra, and you might notice Kyle is a younger inventor. At only age 17, he's here at the Colorado Inventor Showcase. Kyle, tell us about your invention.
I invented the spot sucker, and I came up with it because I spilled some Gatorade on my shirt, and I'm kind of a lazy kid, and so I saw some Kleenexes, and I saw I could try to scrub it out with the Kleenexes, but knew that it would just kind of deteriorate, not really work. So I kind of thought to myself, why couldn't you have a pump? It actually sucks out that stain and removes that stain. And I went home, thought about it a little bit more, and that's where I came up with the spot sucker.
So tell me, after you conceptualized the idea, what was the next step?
Inventing is this crazy thing. Everybody has ideas, and the hard part is getting them out there. And so now I went home and I thought about it more, and then I came up with my proof of concept prototype. And now we're just trying to get out there and license it so we can sell the idea to some company that will then sell the product.
Okay, tell us about that next step in terms of our marketability. How are you going to get this out to market? Are we going to see you on an infomercial near us?
I don't know. I think it'd be kind of cool to be on an infomercial, but since it's using chemicals and we're not chemists, we need to give it to some other company and let the other company that already deals with chemicals license it out to them and let them deal with it.
Tell me, how are you protecting the idea today? Because obviously this is your brainchild. How are you protecting the idea?
Right now we're patent pending. So we filed a patent a couple months ago. And then we have two trademarks. We have Spot Sucker is actually reserved, and so is Stain Sucker. And it was because in the beginning, we kind of liked both names, not quite sure which one to go with. And plus it's kind of a nice defense where nobody else could come and then take Spot Sucker as their name because they're kind of close.
All right, what advice would you give to young inventors in particular?
Kids are great inventors. A lot of people don't realize that, but kids are trained to be observant. We're supposed to be learning. We're supposed to be seeing things and picking up on them. And because we're observant, we see problems and we have problems that other people don't have. And so just kids can be inventors too. Everybody's at the same place. You have an idea, and then it's just going to the next level. Kids are on the same place as everybody else.
You seem to have so much confidence. I mean, you're here with a bunch of adults. Tell me about how it is to be 17 at the Colorado Inventor Showcase.
It's pretty cool. I mean, I'm very blessed with my mother and her willingness to put up with me and help me move these ideas further. And I don't know, it's a great feeling.
Do the other kids at your school know that you're an inventor? I mean, do they know you're here today?
A lot of them knew that I was on American Inventor. Some of them know I was here today. I don't know, I think I'm kind of quiet about it. And I'm waiting for, I don't know.
You're waiting for your millions. We know. Yeah. We know you're waiting for your big shot, right?
I'm waiting for my product, and then I can be like, yeah, that's mine.
That is so exciting. Kyle, we wish you all the best this year. Okay. And obviously, as you go forward getting this product to market, look for it on a TV infomercial near you.